Hey, I'll be with you real quick.
We're having some technical difficulty. Oh, look,
Right. Is
we're
everyone
live.
here to join me yet? No, not yet. Well, I'm Eddie Hoschlag, and welcome to the first annual Natural Health Cooking Show. Not really a cooking show, but I'm going to tell you a little bit about cooking. Cooking. A lot of things are going good already. So the first thing I wanted to kind of bring up is you can kind of see a trend of this grocery store kind of buying the grocery stores compared to people actually eating or drinking at establishments. We can go a lot of ways with this, but we can look through it depending on the generations as well. If you can see that dark bar graph is stating that do not have time to cook. And the little lighter bar graph there says rather spend time doing other things. Totally makes sense. We're in a very, very high demand world here, but I want to kind of break down a couple of things before we actually get to our basic kind of cooking show things. So when I looked online, they said there's excuses out there for not cooking. Well, the first excuse it says, well, I don't know how to cook. Well, if you don't know how to ride a bike and you want to ride a bike, would you want to consistently start riding a bike? Probably. So if you want to keep trying to have a cook, maybe you want to just start trying to cook. You know, that might work out pretty well. So the next one is, I don't feel like cooking or eating tonight. Makes sense. You come home very busy, but I'm going to show you some ways to making sure that you can actually eat when you're at home because you have meal prep throughout the whole entire day. Now, I'm on a diet. I can't be in the kitchen. Well, if you're on a diet, let's give you the right nutrition behind it or your diet's recommendations so we can eat that at every meal. There is nothing to eat in the house. Okay, good one. That's great. So we are both at work and we're tired to get home to cook. Well, have you ever tried all the other options out there? We're going to go through a couple of them. You know, it's faster to get takeout, delivery, or fast food, and that's debatable because there's a lot of great tools out there that we can find out that even going all the way to the store or takeout and bring it all the way back, you would already have a home cooked meal. So the next one is, I don't want to clean up the mess. Yet again, a lot of the technology that we have in our cookingware today is very easy to clean. You throw it in the dishwasher, you get a rag, clean it all off, and you're good to go. Very easy, and it's probably just as quick as throwing all your take-home or take-out trash in the trash can. Everyone wants something different to eat. Yet again, if we try to meal prep accordingly to everybody in the actual family, then we can find out that we can hit every single person that wants it. And this is my interesting one. It says it's too expensive. Well, it doesn't make sense when we go to the same exact lines in the positives of cooking, and you'll find out that it says it's cheaper than actually takeout. But what I like to look at is the positivities of cooking. You know, we can find out that a lot of this stuff, you know, the cooking itself is a creative art. It's a culinary art. So if we want to actually use our creative mind in that sense, so we can use that to find out how to be more passionate about it. We can improve our relationship with food. When we put more intention inside of it, more gratitude in the food, we can actually get much more out of it rather than scarfing it down and going back to work or playing video games or anything like that. Food is a very good way to actually improve your relationship with the food and the other people around you. The feeling of accomplishment, yet again, it's just like putting anything else. If like you're going to build a Lego set or you're building something else, if you want to enjoy it, you're wanting to try to put in the work before to actually enjoy it at the end, just like a meal here. It gets you into the flow. I love feeling the flow. Some people call it kind of like a download, but I usually kind of have it more of a writing sense when things are just kind of in the flow. And cooking is essentially the same way. Once you just kind of get everything rolling, you get everything cut up, you're putting it in the soup bowl or whatever you want to make it, that flow is just very, very good to kind of get that mind getting more of the creative mindset and letting it flow naturally through the body. So it improves your quality of life in many, many ways. We've already talked about a couple of them, but who knows, depending on your personal life, there could be ones that make it much, much better. This is a good one that I always think is fun, even just kind of talk with my family. It's always fun just having that good feeling of just serving others, you know, cooking for others in a sense. So if we get that good sense of feeling, it makes it much better to like feel accomplished after that. Putting all these positivities in cooking, then you can find out that you won't need as many excuses, but you can get so much more out of it. So even just connecting with others, it could be family, friends, have that time out throughout the day to sit down and enjoy the company. if we enjoy that company, we won't probably won't, you know, make so many arguments throughout the day when it comes to, oh, I wish I had more time to do this, this, and that. Well, if we get a really good connection with the family or our friends, you can see a lot of those other problems can probably dissipate. So patience, patience is a good one, depending on what we're cooking. But today we're going to show you some very easy ways to cook that'll take probably 10 to 15 minutes tops, depending on what we're using. The next one is you're helping your brain stay healthy. Very true when it comes to the creativity. So, and lastly, like I just talked about as well, it saves you money. So we can kind of look at the secondary things. I talked about a little of them though, is a patience can help us out in so many ways. If we can help build that skill of patience in our mind, then who knows if this patience of cooking something could go into, you know, waiting in line at the DMV or waiting in line somewhere else. It can control and help you so much more throughout the other daily things in your life. So we can keep that patience up, let you get in the flow to enjoy cooking more or enjoy other arts activities. The more creativeness that you can use not only in cooking, but even the things, you know, throughout your work life. You might actually get a promotion by using the creativity of creating more foods. You're using that same creativity in your actual work life, and you can find out that you could be helping so many more other places, the secondary positives. You know, I always go back to it, and I went back to it in my other presentation, but gratitude works so well when it comes to the cooking your own food. But yet again, our everyday emotions of stress cause us to be in this fight or flight. So if we have this home-cooked meal and we sit down, we're very, very grateful to have it, and we're so accomplishing taking care of this meal for our family and ourselves, then we can find out that it actually shows it's going to put us in the very parasympathetic or rest and digest place. So not only are you feeling gratitude towards the food that you've created and you've created this masterpiece art, but you're also helping yourself actually digest these foods and making sure you can absorb much more of this nutrients. So we aren't really much what we eat. We are what we digest and assimilate. So I just kind of talked about that. So really, when we make our foods, are you actually optimizing the absorption of nutrients and all the food that you've created? And when I talk about, you know, creating this environment for your food, I always go back to the subconscious mind, because this goes directly when it goes back to, you know, building the habit. You know, maybe once you cook a meal and kind of you get off of it for a little, get some takeout, but really kind of making that a habit and actually forming that habit within the whole family of sitting down for the whole entire meal, it can slowly progress to being just a second nature thing. That's the big thing that I wanted to focus on, because when we look at those excuses at the beginning, well, are they excuses or are they just not built up habits? And that's the beautiful thing of making a health an actual priority. So if you look at all of these, you can actually explain it in a deeper sense. Well, it's faster to get takeout, delivery, or fast food. Well, did you make a habit to going to get takeout, delivery, or fast food, or did you enjoy or make a habit of, you know, having patience of cooking your own meals at home? And a lot of these can go in the various different ways, depending on how much effort or how much are you making a priority towards your health. A lot of the stuff I'll be going over today is going to be very easy to clean. All the things are easy to clean. It's just the excuses or habits that we are built onto in the past with our own cooking. And yet again, it's not actually expensive at all. The fun thing that I kind of looked at this, if you're going to have a home-cooked meal with your family, then why don't we just you know, make a fun experience out of the cooking part? Well, if you lose $10 on a burnt meal, it's essentially doing the same exact thing to go into Bonkers or the Scotty Skateland or something like that, somewhere fun, but you're able to enjoy that experience and the communication with the family throughout this whole entire time that you're cooking. Got a burnt meal? Fine. Go get some takeout. So what I'm looking for is a couple of things. You know, what is easy? What is fast? What is, you know, what's good for cleaning? And then the nutritional value behind it. Nutritional value is a big thing that I'm looking at, because the way that we're looking at diets is more of, you know, kind of getting rid of a lot of the sugar or the things that are causing us harm on our day-to-day life. So when we kind of look at these different ways of eating, I always love the toaster oven, the waffle maker, the air fryer, and the crock pot. So we're going to go through each individual one here and kind of demonstrate you, you know, how easy and essentially it is, so we can get more time for, you know, enjoying with the family or anything down those lines. So my cameraman's going to turn my camera over here, and we're going to look at this waffle maker first. So the first thing we're kind of going off here is this waffle maker that we have going on, is you can get these ingredients done and ready to go in the morning. The favorite thing that I like to do is we actually grind up some chicken, some cheddar, and then some bacon, and all mix it all up together. And you can make waffles out of this, but you can also make, you know, even just buns. So if you actually put this all in the thing, you crock it up and you turn her on, well, it's going to take 10 minutes tops to get two sandwiches ready to go. So that's two people's sandwiches, 20 minutes, you've got yourself a whole meal ready to go for itself. Now, if we're looking at the nutritional density, when it comes to nutritional values in the food and our dietary recommendations, we got to think of, well, do we need a three-course meal to plan? Well, not essentially, no. So if we find ourselves a very easy way to use this waffle maker, it doesn't have to be waffles and syrup or anything like that, but if you do want to have some fun, I'm sure there's a lot of great recipes that you can throw a lot of good peanut butter on there, maybe some butter or coconut oil on top of there if you had some almond flour waffles. That is very good. Another fun one that we kind of looked up before this, and I do have it in the description box, some plenty of waffle recipes, but it was like a taco waffle or like a quesadilla waffle. So really, if you want to just mix all your taco seasonings or anything in those together, well, you just got yourself a taco. You didn't have to make all the meat, prepare all the meats and the seasonings. You just throw it in a bowl, put it in the waffle, and then you got it. It's easy, it's fun, and think about the time actually preparing it with your family. So if one's cutting up the onions or one's peppers, the grinding up the meat, let's just make an experience out of this so you can accomplish your gratitude or your feel-good feelings making it with the family but also eating it. So that's all I kind of had for the waffle maker. Another fun thing I actually saw too is if you just get any kind of vegetables, so like cucumbers, eggplants, you can just throw them in there, cook it, and it's going to be the same exact thing as putting it on the grill. So the next one that I look at is the bottom one here is the toaster oven. The toaster oven is really just a kind of a smaller version of an oven, but just actually going to kind of save a lot of energy. There is a lot of conferential things going out there about the microwave. Well, it emits a lot of this radioactivity that can cause a lot of harm to the body. So the oven doesn't. And it actually cooks it much, much better and makes it much crisper. You can kind of do a microwave when you cook something back up, like a pizza or something, and it'll actually make it kind of soggy. Well, the toaster oven actually cooks it back up. And they make them so big now that you can probably put a lot of different chickens in there, anything to cook whole to the whole entire family. So I'm just trying to think the other one. But yeah, there's so many different recipes out there that you can just kind of put it in there. So another one is just the chicken quesadillas. They have a portobello pasta, burgers, paleo pizza, shish kebabs, glazed salmon. You know, if you have the meat or any of the food thawing out for the whole entire day, once you get home, you can just prop it in there and it's going to be done within 20 minutes. During the cooking time, you can go change, you know, kind of get some music, turn the music on, you know, get everything kind of comfortable for the whole family to enjoy. So the next one's going to be the air fryer. And this is the big guy I think that's coming up recently because it is so convenient and it's actually probably the fastest one here, maybe even faster than the actual waffle iron here. But yet again, you got to just thaw things out throughout the day, prop them in. Actually, I don't even think you could thaw them out. This then cooks it so evenly just because it's all air fried and there's no grease, no anything. You can keep the grease if you want and save it for anything. But the big thing is I think you could put maybe some fish, meat, veggies, whatever you really want, just throw it in there and try it out. There's plenty of recipes online. I will have them in the description box as well to how to use this air fryer. So if you want to kind of come over here and I'll kind of show you the crock pot. Now the crock pot is my favorite because the crock pot, I always like cooking a lot of things slowly when it comes to this. And the fun thing is I actually kind of cheated the system. They actually make crock pots that have a little timer on there. But if you have a crock pot at home and if you don't have a timer on there, just use a Christmas light timer. It's going to do the same exact thing. You set it up in the morning. You actually, you know, the fun thing is if you actually meal prepare, that'll be another fun activity to do with the family, is on Sundays or on the weekend, you kind of gather up all the things that you want to meal prep every single thing throughout the week, or you want to do a whole month, get everything ready to go, freeze it in freezer bags, and then that morning, you put your freezer bag in here, put your timer on maybe at like 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so it takes 4 hours to cook. Then once you get home, it'll actually be cooked and ready to go for you. So some people say they go home and they feel like they're tired and they're exhausted. Well, once you smell that home-cooked meal that you've done and prepared for months ahead, maybe weeks ahead, it doesn't matter, you'll feel like I'm probably gonna eat now. So that was a big thing that I always enjoyed loving. I mean, there's so many recipes. I think probably out of all of these, this is probably the most abundant of recipes. So cracked chicken, sausage stuff, mini sweet peppers, broccoli, cheddar soup, cheddar, buffalo chicken. The list goes on and on. And the neat thing is, and I know I just wanted to kind of emphasize here, is I think it's the fun of actually creating these things. You can have the actual recipe itself, I mean, whether it's a crock pot, the toaster oven, the air fryer, but just enjoy the experience of it. It's going to make it taste so much better. And the gratitude of actually enjoying that experience with your family or yourself, you know, just that creativity will do so much more for the mind than you actually think about. But another thing that we would like to kind of emphasize too is to get those healthy fats in. This is a neat one that we always like, the organic chicken broth, but as well as back here, if you have anything going on with the waffle maker, or you have any burgers that you're cooking up in the air fryer, Primal Kitchen is actually a really good brand that we love to use, maybe salad dressings. They even have some good ketchup as well as some spicy brown mustard. I actually like this one a lot. And then mayo. You can get all these things that are just delicious, and they're also nutritious. So you can kind of keep those all in mind. So some very cheap ways that a lot of people have these excuses, but these excuses can be supported with a lot of these different instruments, this technology, if you consider that, to help you out and kind of get those habits going to make it stick in that subconscious mind. Because once you get it flowing, you make 10 meals out of this, and then you got to get those in the freezer, you can have plenty of these, plenty of other meals the other night, plenty of other meals the other night. You know, use your own creativity, making sure you make that habit, because I guarantee it, once you make that habit to have a sit-down meal, a lot of these things are going to happen towards your family as well. Because remember, when we talk about kind of making a habit, we're talking about the subconscious mind. But when we're talking about the subconscious mind, you got to understand that between the ages 0 and 7, kids are just straight subconscious mind. So if you make a habit out of them to enjoy a family dinner every single night, that will translate to their actual future. They will love their family much more, and they will actually appreciate the habit of sitting down and enjoying the meal. But if we have, and we just got to get takeout, we get some fast food, well, do you think they're going to actually appreciate the meal that's actually going on? So I just want to kind of bring it back over here. We're going to kind of finish up this presentation. The little that I did before, come on over here. And kind of finish her off, just like every other presentation that we have. The next health shop that we have is going to be Gut and Brain Connection, and that's going to be on March 16th. I think Dr. Shipp is going to have a lot of great things going on with that, just because the spine is very important when it comes to that gut and brain connection. And of course, please like us, share us, just give us some love when it comes to the Instagram and Facebook. We will have these on YouTube as well as Brighteon. So if you do have anybody that might have some interest in, helping them out kind of eat a little bit better, kind of take care of their food when they kind of are eating at home, let us know. Send them our way. We will have these on our Facebook page, as you very well know. But other than that, I very do appreciate everything that you've done, kind of combined being here with us today. And I hope you have a great day. Thanks.